गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, गुड आफ्टरनून एज वेल। आई होप आई एम ऑडिबल टू एवरीबडी। टुडे एज पर योर प्रपोजल एंड डिमांड आई एम जस्ट गोइंग टू रिवाइज दिस चैप्टर वंस अगेन। लेट्स स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द बिगनिंग, द कंपनी अकाउंट्स चैप्टर नंबर 6। एज यू नो कंपनी ऑलवेज रिमूव द ड्रॉबैक्स ऑफ सोल प्रोप्राइटरशिप एंड partnership, the major drawback that is the sources of funds. In case of company, the company has a huge amount of funds and it can be acquired with the help of share capital. So it is very important to understand the concept of share capital first of all before understanding the accounting treatment of companies. What is share capital? Share capital means the capital raised by the company by issue of shares. Many individual and institution contribute varying sums to the company's capital, yet there is no separate capital account for each of these individual or the institution. No separate account, I'm telling you again, is to be prepared for these kind of capital. A complete consolidated share capital account of the company is to be prepared. I'm repeating, share capital means the capital raised by the company, capital raised by the company by the issue of shares. Any of the individual can purchase the company of the share, any of the institution can purchase the company of the share or invest money in the company's share. So no separate account is to be prepared in case of company. A consolidated capital account is to be prepared and which is known as share capital. First of all, this concept should be clear to everybody. The second thing, the kinds of the share capital should be clear to you. What are the kinds of share capital? These are as follows. The number one, authorized capital, registered capital, or nominal capital. Authorized. Authorized refers to that amount which is stated in the memorandum of association and it is the maximum capital for which a company is authorized or registered to issue the shares during its lifetime. The second one is the issued capital. Issued capital is that part of authorized capital which is offered to the public for subscription, and the remaining part of the authorized capital is known as unissued capital which can be issued later on. Let's have an example. Suppose a company gets the authorized its capital of rupees 1 lakh. It means the authorized capital or the registered capital will rupees 1 lakh and company issued 50,000 rupees or the share of 50,000 rupees out of those authorized capital, then issued capital will rupees 50,000. Let it be the per share value is 10. If we divide the total value of the capital by 10, we will get the number of share issued. That become the issued number of shares. The next one is the subscribed capital. For example, when the public, when the company issues 50,000 shares, but it is subscribed by the public only 48,000, means public apply for the 48,000 shares. In that case, it is undersubscribed and subscribed capital will be rupees 48,000. If public apply for more, let it be public apply for 50,000 rupees share capital, then in that case it is the case of oversubscription. But if the company issued 50,000 rupees share capital and public applied over the 50,000 rupees capital, then it will be known as the fully subscribed. Complete subscription is there. So we will learn the treatment of the under subscription. We will learn the under treatment of the fully subscription. We will learn the treatment of oversubscription as well later on in following or upcoming examples. Before that, the concept of the subscribed capital should be very much clear to you because it is taken under two heads in the company's balance sheet. A, subscribed and fully paid up capital. B, subscribed but not fully paid up capital. For example, sometimes a company has the share of rupees 10 per share and public applied for 48,000 as we quoted the example. What happened in that case? The per share value is 10. Company don't want to call the 10 rupee altogether. Company wants to make a call of rupees 6 in first year and 4 in next year. Then these kind of shares are known as the subscribed but not fully paid up shares. These will be known as subscribed but not fully paid up shares. And sometimes this can be happen as well, that the company, some shareholder don't pay the amount. Company called 10 rupees, but shareholder paid the less amount, then it is also known as the subscribed but not fully paid up capital as well. We have to show subscribed and fully paid up capital as well as subscribed and not fully paid up capital in the books of account or in the company's balance sheet. Let's see on the next page that what is the format of the company's balance sheet. Please scroll the screen. Yes, come to the next page, and a pro forma of the company's balance sheet is floating on the screen. Look at the format very carefully. My dear student, always keep one thing in your mind. Most of the time, you find the treatment of the share capital in the balance, company's balance sheet, in case of company account, according to chapter number 6. So it is very much compulsory to learn the what should be the accounting treatment, how the items are to be present, what are the heads, what are the subheads. See, it is in the part. It will become subscribed and fully paid up. Whether in the first year, if the company calls the complete amount in the first year, in first year it becomes subscribed and fully paid up. If company calls the partial amount in first year and call the next partial amount in next year, in the next year it becomes the fully paid up, but in first year it becomes fully paid up. Any other doubt to anybody? Yes. Is it clear to you, beta?
Thank you.
Okay. Any other doubt to anybody? Yes, beta, speak. Horizontal. But now you have, the balance sheet of sole trade and partnership horizontal form. But in case of company, the balance sheet is to be prepared according to Company Act 2013 Schedule 3 in the vertical form. First of all the equity and liabilities are to be shown. Under that, all the assets are to be shown, but for this chapter you have to show the treatment of company's share capital. The main heading is equity and liability. Under that, shareholder funds are to be shown, in which share capital that is to be calculated in the notes to account that I'm just going to discuss within few minutes. B, reserve and surplus. C, money received against share warrants. Money received against share warrants only is to be mean for the theoretical point of view. It is not to be evaluated practically in 12th class. So learn it theoretical only. And let's see what is to be explained in share capital and reserve and surplus on the next page in notes to accounts. Please scroll the screen. Yes. Here the notes to accounts are floating on the screen right now, in which you just come to know what are the subheads of share capital. Share capital consists of authorized capital, issued capital, subscribed capital. Keep one thing in your mind, my dear. Authorized and issued capital is just shown and closed. It is not added somewhere else in the balance sheet, but it is shown in the balance sheet. Whatever the value of the share, authorized, registered, or the nominal capital known of the company is to be shown first of all. Then issued capital is to be shown, whatever the amount issued by the company. And after that, the major concept, subscribed capital, is to be shown, in which please zoom your screen and see very carefully, subscribed and fully paid up capital is there. and subscribed but not fully paid up capital there. You have to add both of these capitals and you will get the total amount of company's share capital. Subscribed and fully paid up, whatever the share that are fully subscribed by the company, and subscribed not fully paid up share in which calls in areas are to be deducted and if any forfeited shares are to be added. We can discuss it more in the examples or the illustration in your queries as well. When you do it practically, you just come to know about it more, or you can watch the video that I sent earlier. So this is all about your company's balance sheet. Now look at the journal entry. How the journal entries are to be done. Please float the screen. Now the entries of issue of shares are given to you. Please minimize the screen a little. Thank you, sir. Here the entries are given to you. I stated whenever the share capital is to be treated, the journal entries are to be passed of due as well as received. Once it becomes due, another time it is received. First of all, what the company will do? First of all, when the company issues the prospectus, in the procedure of issue of share, in one of the video we have done, when the company issue the prospectus, public apply for the share, it means first step is taken by the company in the monetary term, that is receiving of the capital. Which capital? In the form of share application. It means first of all, after issuing the prospectus, the monetary transaction that is take place, that is receiving of company's share application amount. Company is receiving the amount, debit what comes in. All the money will receive through DD or checks. So bank account debit to share application account. Debit what comes in, so bank account will be debit, and the source of company's income is share application. So share application will be credited. So on the receipt of application, the journal entry is to be passed bank account debit to share application account. Whatever the number of shares are received, the public multiplier per share value is to be multiplied. After that, the capital is transferred to share application account is transferred to share capital account. The entry will be subscription, their money is returned. In that case, the entry will become reverse. Please float the screen, sir. Entry will become income bank account debit to share allotment account. Then company make the calls after allotting the shares. First call due, the calls can be maximum 3. When the first call due, the entry will become share debit to share capital account. On the receipt of first call money, the entry will become bank account debit to share first call account. Please scroll the screen, sir. Keep in your mind, whenever you have to pass the entry in case of company accounts, you have to pass the entries of due as well as receipt. Two entries in each case is to be done. Application, allotment, first call, second call. All in all, it will become the total 8 entries. In case of the final call or the second call, the same. The entry of due and entry of received is to be done. Now let's do illustration number 5. The entries will become more clear to you. Pawan Limited invited the application of rupees 30,000 of 10 each. Payments were to be made as follows: rupees 3 on application, 3 on allotment, 2 on first call, 2 on final call. Please underline the number of shares application invited. It means these are issued number of shares and the total value will be the issued value. 30,000 share into 10 each. It means the 30,000 into 10, 3 lakh rupees will become the issued capital. Out of that, payments were to be made 3 rupees on application. Keep in your mind, whenever you have to pass the entry of application, consider the value of application rupees 3, not rupees 10. Rupees 10 is the complete value of the shares and you have to consider the value of rupees 3. That is share application. Then rupees 3 on allotment. Whenever you have to pass the entry of allotment, rupees 3 are to be considered per share. For first call, rupees 2. For final call, rupees 2. Please, sir, stop. I have to read the statement first. All the shares were applied. You are required to prepare the journal entries, ledger account, and show the share capital in the company's balance sheet. Keep in your mind, only the share capital is to be shown, not the complete balance sheet is to be prepared. Assuming that all the sum due to allotment and call have been received, issue of share expense amounting to rupees 8,000. A further entry related to share issue expense is to be done as well. 4,000 fully paid up share were also issued to promoter for their services. Now, let's come to the solution part. See the solution. First of all, the entry of the receipt of the share application is to be done. The entry will become bank account debit. Debit what? Comes in. What is coming to the company in the source of income? The share application amount. The share application amount is received by the company, so it is to be credited. The journal entry will become bank account debit to equity share application account. And what will be the amount? 30,000 is the application money. 3 rupees per share is there. 30,000 into 3. The value will become 30,000 into 3, 90,000. I'm telling you again and again, when you have to attempt the solution at the time of application money, consider the amount of application per share, not the complete value of share. At the time of allotment, on the date of allotment, application money transferred to the share capital. The entry will become equity share application account debit. Whatever you received with application is due to share capital account, and the journal entry will become to equity share capital account. On the date of allotment, the allotment money will become due, and the journal entry will become equity share allotment account debit to equity share capital account. 30,000 shares are there. 3 rupees per share is there. 30,000 into 3. The total amount of the share allotment is due rupees 90,000. At the time of receipt, the entry will become bank account debit to equity share allotment account. The 90,000 amount will be received by the company because it is assumed that third last line of the statement, all the sum due on allotment and calls have been received. So this point is making you clear that all the money received by the company, no arrears are there, no forfeiture are there. Please scroll the screen, sir. Here we did the entries of application received, application due, allotment received. Scroll the screen, please. So, on the date of the call money due, the entry will become equity share first call account debit to equity share capital account. 30,000 shares are there. 2 rupees per share on first call. The total amount of the equity share first call will be 60,000. At the time of receive of first call, the journal entry will become bank account debit, means debit what comes in, to equity share first call account rupees 60,000. On the date of second call, the entry will become, or the final call, equity share final call account debit to equity share capital. Again, 30,000 shares multiplied by 2 rupees per value share, 60,000. Please scroll the screen. After that, the receipt of the first call, final call entry is there, equity share final call to equity share capital, then bank account debit to equity share final call account. Please look at the statement. You find the second last line, that share issue expense amounting to rupees 8,000. These are expense for the company. And what is the rule of generalizing? Debit all expenses and losses. So share issue expense account debit to bank account. Credit what goes out. Whatever is going out from the company is to be credited always. And debit all expenses. The entry will become share issue expense account debit with the rule debit all expenses and losses. And credit what goes out, because bank or cash is our real account, and the rule applied, credit but goes out to bank account rupees 8,000. Next is given that share issued to the promoters. Whenever the share issued to the promoters, the entry will become incorporation post account, because whatever the share issued to them, it is treated as the cost considered for the incorporation, means preparation of the formation of the company. So it will be known as incorporation cost or formation expense account debit to equity share capital account, means share issued to the promoters for their services. Here all the notes given to you, that hints that I also explained you. The first thing, application money received entry is passed first, then it is transferred to the share capital thereafter. In another case, first of all it is due, then it is received. Second note is given, in case of allotment, first call and second call, the entry of transferring to the share capital remains same first, and then receive is to be done. The third point is given, in case of nothing is mentioned about the share issued, it is always treated as equity share. Mark the word equity as well. I hope the first full-fledged portion is clear to you, in which you just come to know how the journal entries of issue of shares, due of application, allotment, first call and final call, receive of application, first call and final call is to be done, and what will be the journal entry of share issue expense and incorporation cost, means share issue to the promoters, are to be done. Let's do example number 6. When the company issued its shares at premium. In previous question, illustration number 5, we have discussed what is the accounting treatment when 10 rupee share is issued at rupee 10, means par. But sometimes, if the company has a good reputation, it can issue its shares more than its face value. Whatever the value is issued more than its face value is known as the security premium reserve. Let's read the statement. The concept will be more clear to you, and if you want to clarify it more, you can watch the video that I sent earlier. Spencer Paints Limited was registered with an authorized capital of rupees 50 lakh. The authorized capital, please underline my dear students, authorized capital of rupees 50 lakh divided into 5 lakh equity share of 10 each. Authorized number of share are 5 lakh, while the authorized capital is rupees 50 lakh. Per share value is 10. Now in this case, authorized capital is different from the issued, because issued shares are 2 lakh equity shares at a premium of 3 per share. So issued capital will become 2 lakh into 10. That will become the issued capital. Company issued the shares at premium of rupees 3, and amount is called as follows: rupees 4 on application, 5 on allotment including premium, 2 on first call, 2 on second and final call. All the shares were subscribed and money was duly received. Share issue expense amounting to rupees 75,000 which were fully written off against the security premium. Please mark this point. It is different from the earlier question. In the previous question, you got only the amount of share issue expense. But in this question, you got the amount of share issue expense which were written off against security premium. In your books, before this question, the ways to write off the security premium is given to you, that where the security premium amount can be used. The security premium reserve amount can be utilized for the return of share issue expense as well. There are many more. From theory point of view, you have to prepare it so well. So pass and SSC general entry and prepare the bank account of the company. Here the general entries are given to you, and the first general entry, sir, please show the general entries. The first entry will become bank account debit to equity share application account as the money received on application. 2 lakh shares are issued, 4 rupee per share on application, the amount will become 8 lakh. Equity share application to equity share capital, again it is due, it is as simple as we did in the previous example. Now please highlight and mark the point in your books related to the share allotment. See, mark a star against it. Equity share allotment account debit to equity share capital account to security premium reserve account. I'm repeating, please mark a star against this entry in your books. Rupees 10 lakh is the total share allotment, where the equity share capital account is rupees 4 lakh. 2 lakh into 2 lakh shares into 2 rupees, while the security premium is 3 rupees. Please mention in your books to security premium reserve account in bracket 2 lakh multiplied by 3. The total amount of the security premium reserve will be 6 lakh. And the total amount of security premium and share allotment will become 6 plus 4, that is 10 lakh. I'm repeating the concept again. In the previous question, the share issued at par, so allotment entry was as remain same as you did of share application. But in this case, the share allotment entry will be something else. You have to credit the amount of security premium reserve account in case of share allotment, because the amount of the security premium is given along with the share allotment. So entry will become equity share allotment account debit to equity share capital account to security premium reserve account. 4 lakh and 6 lakh amount is there, and total equity share allotment will become 10 lakh. Now the receipt of application share equity share allotment, the entry will become bank account debit to equity share allotment account, that is rupees 10 lakh. Please mark in your books equity share first call account debit, in bracket mark the amount how you will get it. 2 lakh shares are there, 2 rupees per share, the amount will become 4 lakh. It is received at the time of money received for first call, the entry will become bank account debit to equity share first call account. In case of second call, the entry due equity share second call or final call debit to equity share capital, 2 lakh into 2, again 4 lakh. Please scroll the screen. Please scroll the screen, sir. The next entry will become bank account debit to equity shares second call and final call at the time of receive of share final call. Now, the share issue expense that is mentioned in the third last line of the statement, that are rupees 75,000, and it is to be written off against the security premium reserve. What is to be done in that case? Two entries are to be passed. In the previous example, you did only a single entry, that is share issue expense, debit all expenses and losses to bank account. But in this case, it is to be written off against the security premium reserve, and the second entry will be passed. Share issue expense, security premium reserve account debit to share issue expense. The expense will be written off against the securities premium. In this case, bank account is to be prepared as well. The entry will, the entries are to be passed. All the entries that you did like this, bank account debit to equity share application, to equity share allotment, to equity share first call, to equity share final call. all entries are to be posted on the debit side of the account. All the entries in which you credited the bank account, the entry will become by share issue expense by balance. Carry down will be the balancing figure. You have to add the debit of all. It will become 26 lakh. Deduct 75,000 credited as share issue expense in this account, and you will get the balance carry down 25,25,000. In this way, bank account is to be prepared. Now let's see how the balance sheet is to be prepared. Scroll the screen, sir, please. See, here the share capital is to be shown in company's balance sheet. How the amount of 20 lakh is going to wind up? See, in share capital, the notes to account are given to you. Authorized capital is there, and issued, subscribed, and fully paid up capital is absolutely same. So, because whatever the company issued, it is subscribed and fully paid up. That is 2 lakh. See, 5 lakh equity share are authorized of rupees 10 each. It means 50 lakh share capital is authorized and marked with the double line. It is not shown above, but the issued, subscribed capital is same. So it is shown above in the heading of shareholder fund. That is your share capital, rupees 20 lakh. The security premium reserve amount that you have received, only 5,25,000. It is shown as the subheading of reserve and surplus. Whatever the balance of the bank account, it is shown in the assets as current assets, cash and cash equivalents. So in this way, you have to prepare the company's balance sheet. It is a full-fledged question. Yesterday, I discussed the issue of shares for consideration other than cash. Today, I have discussed the public subscription of shares issued at par as well as premium. Now, bank account also has been discussed. Balance sheet has been discussed. Types of capital has been discussed. Now, you have to complete your question up to the topic of share issued for consideration other than cash. Thank you. Have a nice day.